Hello everyone, and welcome to the next part of my Pokemon Sacred Gold Let's Play. Okay, well I am already in the middle of a battle. That is because I was actually searching for a Pokemon that I want to catch, and of course I'm gonna add that Pokemon to my team. So, it's gonna be a Scyther, which is eventually gonna become a Scissor, if everything goes according to plan. So yeah, I'm actually looking forward to playing with another Bug Pokemon. You know Pursuit? Well, that is not a good thing, I guess. So yeah, I'm gonna have to use a potion or something pretty soon. Right, otherwise you're gonna, like, kill my Pedocrunch, and I don't want that to happen. Although, I don't really care. I mean, he's just my HM slave, and I'm actually planning to switch out my Pedocrunch for Scyther when time comes, I guess. Like, I'm actually gonna switch out immediately. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so one more move to go. I guess I should go for the Rock Smash, simply because it's not gonna be very effective. I can actually do a couple more Rock Smashes, as long as you don't kill my Pokemon, that's good. Okay, now I guess I have to start throwing some Pokeballs at you. I'm actually gonna throw some Great Balls at you, and I catch you in the first Pokeball. Okay, well, your data was added. It slashes through grass with its sharp sights, moving too fast for the human eye to track. Okay, he's partial flying, partial bug, and eventually he'll become a steel Pokemon. So yeah, that means that he'll be resistant to a lot of elements as well. That's fucking amazing, this Pokemon. Now why did I decide not to use Heracross? Okay, sure, Heracross is my favorite Pokemon. Well, actually, I'm gonna explain that after this. Yeah, I'll be back in a second after having given him a nickname. I need to use the right tense, or otherwise my English will suck. Okay, I decided to call him Dual Horny. Okay, that was a lot. I said that a lot. Okay, so I'm gonna call him Dual Horny, and now I get a phone call from Wade. Let's take a look. Arno, howdy, it's Wade, how are you? I found all kinds of berries if you want, I'll share some with you. I'll be waiting on Route 31. Well, I don't want your fucking berries, you freak. Okay, now I guess I need to go to the Pokemon Center, but I'm gonna be smart for once. And if possible, I'm gonna use teleport, but that is not possible because I had already decided to get rid of that or something. I don't really know. Now let's go to the Pokemon Center the long way, I guess. Okay, so yeah, I'll be trying to play with a Scissor, and I was explaining why I decided not to use a Heracross, because yeah, I like Heracross a lot, but I've already used him in my Pokemon Liquid Crystal Let's Play from quite a while ago. And back then, he wasn't really that good, and I want to use something new. I know that Scissor is kind of overused. It's not that much of an original Pokemon, maybe. I don't really know, but still, I've never played with him before, and I think I deserve to play with him as well! And I'm not gonna start crying, though. Okay, so I also decided to do something off-screen, which is... Yeah, give me a second, I'll show you guys my box. This is my box, it has the Egg, Ditto, also a Sudowoodo, which I caught in the last episode. And I also caught this Pokemon while I was doing all the Rock Smashes, trying to get a old Amber so I can, like, get an Aerodactyl. By the way, I decided to give up on that idea, even though I managed to get another fossil. As you can see, I have two Omanytes. I managed to find a Helix fossil or something, but yeah, he's just not gonna be that necessary for my team. I think I've already got another Pokemon that I wanna use in his stead. Now, let's quickly withdraw my Dual Horny. Dual Horny actually comes from the nickname that I gave to my Heracross, which was Unihorny, because Heracross has one horn, and I decided to turn it into Unihorny from Horny and stuff. And he has, like, two arms, two blade scissors, you know what I mean. And that's why I call him Dual Horny, and I think it's a pretty cool nickname. His moveset is Pursuit, False Swipe, and Agility. And I'm also gonna take a look whether I can already teach some TMs or something to him, because right now, it's not that good. His physical attack is much better than his special attack, so I'll try to teach a lot of physical moves to him. He can actually learn U-turn, which is a good thing, I guess. I'm gonna get rid of Focus Energy, because I don't really need that. Okay, now, are there any other moves? I'm actually gonna show you the other screen, because I think it's much more fun to watch. Grass Knot, that's not that good. Then you have Shockwave, Dig, Attract, Thief. This is hard. I don't really have that many good TMs yet, so yeah, I'm not gonna teach anything to you now. Okay, well, so much for that. I was actually doubting between him or Absol, which I could catch, like, after I get my 6th badge. I was doubting between those two, and I decided to pick Scissor, because I've never played with that Pokemon before, and I really do like the fact that he's partial steel and stuff, so he'll be a good companion. He'll be a good dog. Okay, now, I guess I should probably play with him, because he's kind of underleveled. Give me a second, Volbeat. I don't need you! For fuck's sake, man! Okay, now, let's change some things in my party setup. All the wild Pokemon, I hate it so much. Oh my goodness. By the way, I'm also really thrilled right now because the sun is shining, even though I'm not allowed to go outside in the sun because I'm taking some heavy pills and stuff. Yeah, my health is not the greatest right now. Still, I like the fact that the sun is shining and people can enjoy their life outside. And then look at me, making videos indoors because I have a life, a social life and stuff. Very sarcastic. Hiya! What the fuck are you doing? These trees may not be bricks, but I can sure give you something to break bricks with. Well, thank you very much. I'm already gonna teach Brick Brick to a certain Pokemon of mine. Well, what Pokemon could that possibly be? Of course not Blaziken. Yeah, of course it is gonna be Blaziken, of course. Mainly because of the fact that he is a partial fighting Pokemon, and he has Stab on that. So yeah, let's get rid of... Let's think... I should probably get rid of Quick Attack, because it's not really that good. Tweedzilla, you learn Brick Brick! Okay. I could have also taught it to my, to my Scyther, but I'm not gonna do that yet. Okay, now let's go onwards. There is a double battle I can do here, probably. Oh, whoa, I'm going way too fast. Tori, let's battle! Alright, I'm bringing out a Pokemon. Tori and Till, those are actually some weird names. Okay, but I've actually not really done that much yet. Oh no, you have an electric Pokemon. That is not what I like, but who really cares about that? Let's go for the U-turn and an air cutter. No, not an air cutter, what am I saying? Extra sensory on the same Pokemon. Mainly because of the fact that I want to kill him off in one hit. Spark is super damn effective, and now Plusle is probably gonna finish off my Pokemon. My dual already, I don't really know. Now let's change Pokemon and go to my Tweedzilla. Mainly due to the fact that he's close to evolving, if I'm not mistaken. And you're not partially flying Pokemon, are you? Okay, now let's do Brick Break and Extra Sensory, and you're gonna... Yeah, hopefully you're gonna kill that fucking Plusle. I really hate those Pokemon. I mean, they look so weak, but they're actually better than you'd think. It's really weird. Okay.
I lost!
Okay. I would have said something really pedophile, but I'm not gonna do so, because I am not sexually attracted to those girls in any way, shape, or form. I am not a pedophile. You guys shouldn't think that. It's not because I say some weird stuff occasionally, that I'm a weird guy, or that I'm a pedophile or anything. No. It's only in anime when I think it's okay to have, like, incest and all that other weird crap. It's only in anime that that can happen for me. Otherwise, it's wrong. Okay, now you have you have two grass Pokemon. I think I have a little problem. Well, let's go for the U-turn on Weeping Bell and go for the extra sensory on Gloom because it's a poison Pokemon and stuff. You know what I mean. Okay, well, Gloom is dead. That's a good thing. Dual Horny is actually not getting that much XP. Now, let's change Pokemon, go to my Nicochan. By the way, I'm gonna switch out Nicochan 2 when its time comes, I guess. Let's take a look. What can I still do? Extra Sensory? Should I do Extra Sensory on Cloyster? I think I should. Hopefully that'll do a little bit of damage. Okay, well, I'm actually quite confused right now. I already know what my team is gonna look like later on. But something's wrong. I already have a plan in my mind, like what sort of team I want to be using and stuff. And, my Nicochan is not gonna be in it, unfortunately. You guys might not agree with that, maybe you will, I don't really know. Now, Water Gun doesn't do that much damage, and you're almost dead now. Bite doesn't even finish you off. Well, that's bullshit. Okay, well, you're dead now. Fuck you, Stormy, fuck you, and your whole crew. I'm level 31, okay. I should probably put my Blaziken as my second Pokemon so he can, like, join the fight together with my Scyther. Give me a second. Oh yeah, by the way, now you guys already know what my Pokemon team looks like at the moment. Do you guys think it's a good team so far? I know that I've already asked this a couple of episodes ago, but I think it's pretty good. And here is Growlithe. Growlithe is not a bad Pokemon, and probably some people would want me to play with him, but I'm not gonna do so because... I think he's kind of overused. I mean, who hasn't played with Arcanine yet? Bill.
Hi, I'm Bill, and who are you?
Arno, huh? You know what? I'm the one who developed the system to transfer Pokemon, but it couldn't have been done by me alone. For example, do you know the Hoenn region? The girl Lynette from Hoenn made the Pokemon storage system easier to use. My friends all over the world are working together to improve the Pokemon trade and storage systems. I have to hurry on back to Goldenrod City and see my folks. Bye-bye! Are you gay or something? You really do resemble... homosexual. Not that there's anything wrong with that. But I don't really like them approaching my male character. Nah. You can still give me titties anytime. Why am I even saying this in my episode? Okay, now let's go onwards. Let's go to the right. Is there anything here? Nope. Have you heard about how aggressive the Pokemon living around the mountain have become? It's unbelievable! Well, I need to conduct more research. Have you heard of the advancements of the legendary trainer mythology?
It's unbelievable!
Whoa, you guys are having a conversation or something? It's totally making sense right now. One guy is talking about how dangerous the mountain is, and the other one is talking about some fucking mythology or something. I'm confused. Okay, now what's up? What's going on here? The rainbow hue Pokemon flying gracefully over the tower, the silvery sparkling Pokemon resting gently upon the whirling seabed. All of this is far beyond my imagination. Then why are you talking about it? You can clearly imagine it, so it's not beyond your imagination. Boss, here is the bell tower. This tower was built as a place of rest for Ho-Oh, the legendary flying-type Pokemon. Since Ho-Oh left, many people have gone up to the tower to try to bring it back, but none have succeeded in making Ho-Oh appear. Morty, the gym leader, is one who has tried. You don't seem to have the Ecruteak gym badge. If you can't even defeat Morty, going up there will be a waste of time. Sorry, but you'll have to leave. Okay. Well, you're a bitch. Okay. Now, I guess I should go onwards. Is there anything else that I can do here except for trying to challenge the gym? Although he's probably not gonna be there, I already know where he's gonna be. Spoiler alert, the burned tower. Ah, you're on an adventure with your Pokemon? What's an adventure without treasure hunting? Am I right or am I right? You sure are right! Now I get a dowsing machine. Pretty good. Okay, now I'm gonna split the recording into two, so be back in a second. Basically, what you can do with that is look around for items that you can't see because they're not like in a Pokeball shape. Now, can I get anything in this house?
This happened when I was young. Flying time.
He's talking about a legendary Pokemon, and it's clearly unclear. I think I'm actually contradicting myself. But anyways, it must be very unclear to notice what Pokemon he's talking about. Now I find TM Shadow Claw. Well, that is something really good. Okay, should I ready teach that to some of my Pokemon? Maybe I could teach it to my Scyther, if he can. No, he can't. Only Tweedzilla can learn it. It's not a bad idea, I guess, but yeah, actually I'm gonna teach it to him. Although, this is tough. You know what, I'm not gonna teach it yet. Simply because of the fact, stop trying to learn that, okay. Simply because of the fact that I might be able to teach it to other Pokemon that I'm gonna get later on. Burnt Tower. Okay, well, my Pokemon hasn't leveled a single bit. Is he actually getting getting XP? Yes, he is. Oh my god. Okay. Yep, I'm gonna have to do some off-screen training with him. Now, what's going on here? UZ says, my name is UZ. I'm on the trail of a Pokemon named Suicune. Oh, and you are? Arno, glad to meet you. I heard rumors that Suicune is here, so I came to look. Take a look at the basement through the hole in the floor. There, Suicune is down there. I could go downstairs, but I know it would run away in no time. I know. I've tried it many times. Okay, so apparently you've tried to, stalk some Suicune, and the poor Suicune always runs away. Now, what do I find here? It's a Shuppet. Well, hello there. I'm gonna try to kill you, because I need the XP, and then I'm gonna be level 20. You reduce the PP of my move. Well, I don't care. You're dead now. Okay, now I'm level 20! Okay, hooray! And look at how much my physical attack rises, that's fucking amazing. Now I'm gonna split the recording into two, so be back in a second. Okay, well, while the first part was actually loading and stuff, I decided to do some training with my Scyther, and now he is level 30. Please don't start freaking out, because I'm gonna use him for a little bit from now on, and yeah, you guys will get to know him, I guess. You guys haven't really gotten to know him that well. He is level 30 now, as you can see. His moveset has actually changed as well. I'll show you. So yeah, now he knows Wing Attack, Slash, Pursuit, and U-Turn, which is a freaking lethal combination on him. His physical attack is also really good and stuff. He will be such a good Pokemon. I'm so goddamn I'm pleased with him. Now, hello there, Magby. This is actually my chance. Would you want me to play with a Magmortar? Well, actually, I've already figured out the team that I want to use in the future, and Magmortar is not a part of it. My name is Morty, I'm Ecruteak's gym leader. Because my old friend Yuzeen is here on trial of Suicune, I decided to investigate the Burned Tower. Ecruteak has a legend about these legendary Pokemon, Suicune, Entei, and Raikou. As the gym leader of Ecruteak, I must have a proper understanding of it. Congratulations, bitch. Okay, now, I'm gonna use a repel or something because... Oh my god, I don't even know what I'm doing right now. Here is a repel. Let's quickly use it, I guess. Now, what is his first Pokemon gonna be? I think it's a flying Pokemon. Yeah, by the way, I'm talking about my rival standing there. I think it's a flying Pokemon. Could be mistaken. I most certainly am mistaken, probably. Maria. I called him Maria, that's right. Oh, it's you. You must be here to catch the legendary Pokemon to make yourself look strong. That's only a dream. You see, the legendary Pokemon suits a trainer like me who has sworn to become the strongest trainer. Battle with Team Rocket Grunts is just right for you. Here is a little rival battle, and I think I'm gonna rape you now. Fucking hell, my Pokemon are so goddamn awesome right now. Your level 25 Pokemon can't do shit against an Aurora Beam. Even if you do Nightshade, it doesn't matter because you're dead now. Murkrow, good game, but you lost, okay? I'm level 31. Pretty damn awesome. Next Pokemon is a Magby. Well, I've got a little Adolf Blub to send out against your Magby. My Pokemon are so goddamn overleveled, and I'm getting a text message right now. I've actually gotten two of them. I hate school. Yeah, it's about school, by the way, if you couldn't figure that out yet. Okay, well, this Pokemon is dead as well. Oh my god. Sorry, this is something about the text message I just received. I'm gonna try to explain it, but first I'm gonna teach Aqua Tail to my Adolf Blub, though I don't know which move I should get rid of. It has 90 base damage, and even though it is a physical move, it's gonna be better than Water Gun, I guess, because that only has 40 base damage. Next Pokemon up is Bayleaf. I'm gonna test out my Tweedzilla now. So yeah, what was up with the text message? Basically, I have to do like a group work thing, and it's like a lot of work, I guess. Because it's for school and stuff, and school is so goddamn useful. Yeah, that's sarcasm, by the way. So yeah, that turned into Rock Slide. That's gonna be quite effective. Okay, so yeah, what am I saying? I'm working in a group with some people. One of them is autistic, and he can't really do that much, and I don't really want to entrust him with that many important tasks and stuff. But the thing is, we really have to start getting, we really have to start working now. And that is what is not taking place right now. And we're trying to, tell him, hey, just start working, or otherwise we're gonna flunk and stuff, and you don't want that to happen now, do you? Well, apparently he does, because he's now looking for all sorts of ways to get out of it. Oh, he actually killed my Pokemon or something. Oh, no, I killed him, but, yeah. Sorry, I was with the U-turn, I wasn't really paying attention. His last Pokemon will be a ghost Pokemon, so let's send out my Voyeur. Kadabra is dead, I'm gonna get a lot of XP from that. Okay, so yeah, he's now looking for all sorts of pretexts to get rid of that, to not have to do that and stuff. Now he's saying that his computer is broken, that his monitor is broken, and that it can't work for school and stuff. And he's gonna make it so that we are gonna fail. And I don't want to have to redo my year because some autistic person who has already given up on everything when it comes to his school and stuff just doesn't feel like letting me pass. Ah, whatever. You would never be able to catch a legendary Pokemon anyway. Well, you certainly wouldn't either because you're so bad. Now I got a phone call from Erwin. Arno, I heard you defeated Whitney. It makes me proud to be your friend. Call you later. Yeah, friend. I have no idea where I got your number from. What the hell? Okay, well, I've got a new friend. Well, that's fucking awesome. Well, this guy here looks like a fire breather. So let's quickly go to my Tweedzilla. Why my Tweedzilla and not my Wartortle? That's because he is close to evolving, goddammit. And I wanna make him evolve as soon as possible. Maybe in this episode, who knows? Then I will have got a new Pokemon plus make another Pokemon evolve, and that's fucking awesome. Now, you send out a poison Pokemon. It's not that good, so yeah. I'm just gonna go for the Ember, I do have Stab on that, and you're dead now, okay. Tweedzilla, not only is his physical attack good, but his special attack is as well. I'm so looking forward to playing with him. Now let's go for the Brick Break. That's actually better than Double Kick, because it has 75 damage instead of 60. Well, yeah, Double Kick is actually 30 plus 30. Now you send out Quilava, I'm quickly gonna kill you off as well. And I should probably trigger the event with the legendary dogs as well. But first I want to make my Tweedzilla evolve, and I can only do that by making him battle Pokemon. Now, I get a lot of XP from that. Thanks for such a heated battle! Yep, and thank you for the XP, I guess. Now I find an antidote, and I bet you on my grandmother's shoes that where I'm looking at right now, there is a hidden item there, but I'm not gonna pick it up. I'm practicing my fire breathing in the burn tower, don't try this at home! I wouldn't even want to try it, because I would probably get burned pretty badly. I'm quite clumsy, so if I would start fire breathing or something, I think I would die. Or make someone else die, that's a possibility as well. Now you're gonna send out Slowpoke, of course I don't want to battle you with my Tweedzilla. Let's switch out to my Dual Horny. By the way, what do you guys think of his nickname, Dual Horny? I think it's pretty original and stuff, you guys know what I mean. I think it's pretty cool. Now let's switch out to my Tweedzilla. And what's gonna happen now? You will already get some XP. Now it's Charmeleon. I'm quickly gonna try to kill you with that, with my Tweedzilla. Tweedzilla. I keep on having the tendency to say Tweedzilla instead of Tweedzilla. I don't really know. It doesn't really matter that much, though. Now I'm level 35. One more level to go. Ah, hell yeah. I want my Blaziken now. I find an HP up, and now I guess let's go down. I mean, I've like 6 minutes left, or 5 minutes left, to make him level up one more time. It makes me want to sing the song from Daft Punk, like,
one more time, I'm gonna celebrate.
You guys know what I mean. Well, these legendary dogs, they're freaking out. They're doing some sort of bunny hop challenge or whatever. And Yuzi is here now. Did you see it? Suicune raced by like a blur right in front of my eyes. I have been chasing Suicune for almost 10 years, but I have never been this close. I'm all choked up. By the way, it was clear to me that Suicune took notice of your presence. Ekritik's legendary Pokemon are said to come to people only when they recognize their talents. Perhaps I should be more aggressive towards Suicune. Anyway, Arno, we will meet again. Sure thing, honey. Sure thing. Okay, now I guess I'm gonna go onwards. I know that I can already go to the gym now. Oh, why, hello there, Cubone. You're a ground Pokemon, aren't you? I should probably pay attention, but still I'm gonna kill you now. Rage barely does any damage and you're dead. Cubone, suck on that. Okay, now I'm gonna get the fuck out of this place because I'm just getting sick of it, I guess. I'm gonna pause the video. I'm sick of it. Okay, give me a second. Okay, well, I went to the Pokemon Center, and now let's go to the next route. I'm gonna keep the gym for the next episode, and I'm gonna try to, like, do it in one go. Now, what do you have to say? What makes a slow Pokemon move before a quick Pokemon? Why, Trick Room, of course! And he gives me the TM Trick Room. Well, thank you very much. I'm never gonna teach that to any of my Pokemon. I'm very sorry for that, but yeah, I don't need it. And what do you have to say? Oh, are you a tourist? You should take a look towards the wonders of Ekritik. Explore the burnt and bell towers. Challenge a gym, it's worth it. Okay, so apparently I can only go to the gym. And I can't go anywhere else. Which fucking sucks. Okay, well, this is the gym, and as you can see, it is a little bit, it's a little bugged. I can't really do anything about it, but this, yeah, the ROM, any ROM, by the way, fails when it comes to dark places where you usually need flash and stuff. Like, for example, the dark cave, it was a little glitched out there. Well, here it is a little glitched out as well, but I think it's not that bad. Okay, but now I can obviously see the route I have to take. I'm sorry about that. Now, you send out Ghastly. But yeah, so yeah, I can't really do anything about that, obviously. I'm sorry, please don't start freaking out on me. Okay, well, I get a lot of XP from this guy, so that's good. I'm just gonna try to get as far as possible until I make my Tweedzilla evolve. Now you're gonna do Pursuit. Well, that's not too damageful, if that's even an adjective. I don't know, maybe you guys can tell me. I mean, yeah, English still isn't my first language, although I do have to say that sometimes I spend an entire day just thinking in English, even without even noticing it, but I'm just like spending the day in English, I guess. Like, not in Dutch. Is this a sign? What the fuck? Why did that disappear? Like, the blackness around it? I don't really know. So yeah, I don't really know whether me thinking in English is like a way of noticing that English is starting to become like my first language or something. I do have to say that I speak better Dutch than English, so it's not like that. But yeah, who cares? Now you do Ominous Wind. What the fuck is Ominous Wind? I've never heard of that before. Shadow Punch. Well, you're dead now, Haunter. At least thank you for the XP. You're probably gonna almost make me level up. Yep, you are. Now you're gonna send out Sableye, which is Dark slash Ghost. Can I do Brick Break against that? I flinch. Are you fucking shitting me? Okay, well, my fighting move doesn't do any damage. And no, are you gonna kill my Tweedzilla? For fuck's sake, man. Let's give my Tweedzilla a potion, and I'll be back in a second until he's dead. Actually, no, I'm gonna keep on going, because I am TB Gaming LP. Nice to meet you people. My commentary style is so fucking bad. Okay, now I'm gonna try to kill you. One more time, one more ember. My fucking god! Every time when I do moves like that, like Fury Swipes and whatnot, I always hit like twice or something, and they always hit 4 or 5 times, and it's really annoying. Well, I'm level 36. Am I gonna evolve now? Please make me evolve. Ah, oh, hell yeah. Ah, so nice. Gaming with drink, please. Leave a comment if you're seeing this. I'm gonna play with your favorite Pokemon, Blaziken. Yeah, Gaming with Drink is actually a guy I know. He also makes Pokemon Let's Plays, also Minecraft videos and stuff. I'm more of a Pokemon channel. He's like a mixture of the two. Now, you want to learn Blaze Kick? The user launches a kick with a high critical hit ratio. It may also leave the target with a burn. Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of Double Kick. Just look at his stats, man. Oh my goodness. Okay. It would actually be a shame if I would have like accidentally gotten rid of what's it called again? Brick Break. That would have been such a failure. But luckily, that's not the case. Okay, so I've got a fucking Blaze Kick, which is a physical fire move, and it's gonna do much more damage than the Ember. It has 90 accuracy. Oh my goodness. So yeah, take a look at my Pokemon, guys. It has 90 accuracy and stuff. Yeah, my Pokemon team look pretty darn awesome. From now on, when I'm gonna like showcase my Pokemon, I'm gonna do it like this. This way you can see my set. Yeah, this way you can see the stats, the item it's carrying, and stuff. Do you think this is a good way to show my Pokemon? Like show the two screens at the same time and stuff. Like you can see the you can see the essential stuff. Nico-chan, he's also pretty good. His special attack is good. Then Dual Horny's physical attack is pretty good. Also his speed and stuff. Yeah, that's a pretty good Pokemon. Adolf Blub, he is overall, like, he's quite a balanced Pokemon, except for the fact that he is quite slow, but it doesn't really matter. Voyeur, in due time, I am gonna get rid of you, but still, you're doing the job, I guess. Smartass, yeah, his special attack, that's all I can say. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm gonna end the episode now. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I do think that I did a lot of things in this episode, like challenging the gym, triggering the event at the burnt tower, reaching the city, catching a Scyther, getting a Blaziken, or making my Combusken evolve into Blaziken. So yeah, I think I did enough. Now, if you fall down here, this is just something so you would know, then you end up at the start of the gym. So yeah, this is actually meant to be a challenge because normally you can't see past these black squares, like outside of the black squares. So yeah, then you have to like guess where you're supposed to walk to. And for example here, where it's like completely black and you think you need to go down. Oh my goodness. I hate my life. I hate my life so much. Give me a second, or actually no, I'm just gonna do it like this. Hello there, Drifloon. Big dash for you. Well, I'll just do like three blaze kicks and that should probably do the trick. What the fuck is the aftermath? Since when is that like a hidden thingy? I don't really know. Huh? Is that something like rough skin or something? I don't really know. Could you guys explain that to me? Because I always forget to look it up and stuff. Now it's a Frostlass. Well, that's a partial ice Pokemon, so that shouldn't be too much of a challenge. And you're dead now. Okay, well, I accidentally beat this old woman as well. That's not... Yeah. I didn't mean that, I'm sorry. Well, now I'm gonna go. See you guys, and see you guys in the next episode as well.